How can you explain the fact that so many Christians believe in the Bible as it is these days, although you claim that it contradicts itself and it's so obvious?
I didn't get the joke, but it does it.
Okay, how can you explain the fact that so many Christians believe in the Bible as it is these days, although you claim that it contradicts itself and it's so obvious?
You see, brainwashing. Brain. We all get brainwashed. See, last time when I came in 77, I was speaking to students and professors in the University of Berkeley, San Francisco. And I said, you are all brainwashed. So one professor stood up and corrected me. He says, no, programmed. I says, I beg your pardon, programmed. We are all getting programmed. You see, we are all programmed from childhood into certain beliefs, certain attitudes. And if nobody comes along with a better understanding knowledge to reprogram you, to deprogram you, you remain there. Because he's like a drowning man. He's found something. You know, you say, look, this book can't help you. It is the spirit within you that has helped you. You have been an alcoholic all your life. And you are looking for a way out. You want somebody to help you. You know, you go home and you see your wife is terrified. You find the children are terrified. They're all getting out of your way. You know what's going on. You know, it's terrible. It's horrible. But what can you do? What can you do? You don't like it, but you are helpless. You are in the clutches of this devil, alcohol. And there comes along a person with a little charisma. And, you know, he says, look, man, think and believe that Christ is there for you. He's done everything for you. He's paid for you. Emotionally, you are in a mood for change. You are like a drowning man, struggling to get out, to save yourself from drowning. And the straw, you know, that you hit upon the straw and you were able to come out. You say, the straw helped me. I says, no, it was the struggle that you have been going on in your heart and mind. The struggle you put up brought you to the shore, not the straw. But now when you are trying to explain that on a logical basis, you say, look, it's your struggle that saved you. Your intention, your sincerity that saved you. So, no, he's thinking that now you're trying to push him back into the mire. No, we are only explaining. But now people have gone through this experience and they're terrified. If they let go of this, Christ died for my sins. He saved me. He says, brother, it is your determination, your will, your faith that saved you. He says, no, Christ saved me. As if he's trying to, he's terrified. He says, you want to drown him again, you want to push him back into it. Which is not the case. So you see now, we have to give the people an alternative. They haven't got it. The only book they know is this. And this book they can see, the bulk of the people, they can see, man, what mess it has made. It hasn't got answers to the problems. So when he lets go, or he grabs anything. Hare Krishna movement. You know, the guys with the little pigtail, they go around dancing with the yellow saffron clothes and with the drumming. No, look. It is the mind. You know, you want something, grab something. I say, I get peace here. I get peace there. So you join the Moonies, you find peace. You join Hare Krishna movement, you get peace. It's any movement. It is what you were yearning for, that you were striving for, and these are just excuses. The straws. It's not the straws that are saving you. So our Christian brothers and sisters, they don't know anything about the Quran. They know nothing about the Quran. If their own book lets them down, what about any Eastern book? The Quran, an Eastern book, what can it do for you? They don't know this book. And the trouble is with us. We haven't done anything to educate them. We ourselves, we don't know anything about the Quran. The bulk of us. How do you speak to a Christian? My Arab brothers, you see, look, no knowledge. You are good Muslims. At heart, maybe you are good Muslims. You know the Quran. But how are you going to explain to them what the Quran says? In your heart and mind, you understand when you say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. Vais qalatil malaikatu ya Maryamu. Vais qalatil malaikatu ya Maryamu. Inna Allah astafaki, wataharaki, wastafaki ala nisa'il alameen. Beautiful. Translate it. Translate it for your hearer. How are you going to translate it? So, well, you see, the angel came and he took, look, what else can you do? You know yourself, you understood it beautifully, mashallah. You know what it says. But now, you don't know the language, you don't know the right terminology. See, you are just a new person here, you know, you are maybe a mathematician and electronics and all that. But this language, how to translate what you are reading, you don't know. So my brother said about you people, he said, look, those Qurans are for the non-Muslim, American. He didn't use the word non-Muslim, but that's what he meant. American, you are, most of you might be born here, you're also American. Muslim, born here, you're American. But he said, no. He had in mind non-Muslim American, so he let them have it. But that's also not good enough. You see, you, I said, you Arab also need it. Believe me, you need this translation. In this environment, at home, you don't need it. Allah, in the sight of Allah, you don't need it. Translations you don't need. But now to talk to this in this ocean of westernization, Christendom, English environment, you need a translation to put the correct words, correct meanings of what you're reading. It's there in the mind, but you can't reproduce it. So now you get the translation, Surah Ali Imran, chapter 3, verse 42, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, like this one here. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So wa is qalatil malaikatu ya Maryamu. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki wa taharaki wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen, that God Almighty has chosen thee and purified thee, chosen thee above the women of all nations. Ya Maryam ukhnuti li rabbiki wasjudi warka'i ma rafi'in. So, O Mary, worship thy Lord devoutly, prostrate thyself and bow down in prayer with those who bow down. Now, if you can memorize that English, you know Arabic already. I have experimented on groups of Arab students in the Ad-Dahran University. You see, I said, now how many of you know? وَإِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَاكِ وَتَحَرَّكِ. How many of you? And almost 80% put up their hands. I said, are you all Hafiz al-Quran? He says, no. He says, how do you know? Well, constant reading. Your language, easy to retain. Right. I says, mashallah. You have done the job. You know it. Now, I said, now, how to improve English? I'm going to teach you how to improve your English. You see, I learn many languages. I know many languages. Samples. I can quote you Indonesian, Swahili, Spanish. What language? Nigerian, Zulu, Tswana, Afrikaans, Zulu, Arabic, Hebrew. What language you want to hear? Tell me quickly. Of this I have name. What language you want to hear? Huh? German. I didn't say German. Come on. Any? The languages I said: Swahili, Indonesian, or Malaysian. You know, Spanish. Huh? Swahili. Se tazameni mikono yangu na migu yangu. Ya guwa ni mimi umwenyewe. Umshige ni mshige ni uone. Waguwa roho, haina mwili na mifupa. No, I learn languages, different languages. It serves my purpose, you see. This Swahili, you see, Hebrew, I wanted to go to Israel to talk to my cousins, delivering the message from the last will and testament of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. So I says, I go to them, talk to them. I says, you see, in the last will and testament of Musa alayhi salam, book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verse 18, it says, Navi akim lahim mikarib akhayhim kamukhawinatati before with the bir. So, I want to speak to my Arab brothers. I don't know Arabic. So I learn, I get the Arabic Bible. So I meet Christian Arabs. I says, you know Arabic? He said, yes. I had an argument with a fellow who was giving me a lot of trouble in Canada at a place called Hamilton. You see, a lecture, at the end of the lecture, this man here is asking me questions and he won't let go. Another question and another question. Fortunately, you haven't got the chance tonight, you see. This is all written on paper, so you've got no chance of coming back in a hurry. But that man there, verbal question, one question, I answer that, another one and another one. Eventually, when the meeting is over, he's still around me, he won't let me go. From his tongue, I can make out he's an Arab. And from his what he's asking, I know he's a Christian. So I said, you Arab? He said, yes. He said, I'm a Christian from the Lebanon. I said, you know Arabic? He said, yes. Of course, he says, that's my mother tongue. I said, go, you don't know Arabic. This is intellectual judo. You know judo? Intellectual. You say, no, I mustn't do it like that. So I said, look, you are 1,000 million, you're doing your own way. Go ahead, I'm not interfering with you. This is my way, you see. When I was young, I did judo, I did boxing, I did wrestling, I did weightlifting. Therefore, you see, I'm 69, I'm still standing straight. So I said, go, go, man, you don't know Arabic. He said, you mean to say you know my language better than me? I says, no, no. I'm ashamed to tell you that I'm a born Muslim, but I don't know Arabic. It's the language of the Quran, it's the language of Jannah, language of my Prophet, but I don't know Arabic. I'm ashamed of myself. Then he said, what do you mean I don't know Arabic? I said, you see, you read this book, the Bible, in your own mother tongue, in Arabic. I said, yes. And I said, you are understanding the exact opposite of what you're reading. Not what is there. If you are told in the Bible, thou shalt not commit adultery, you are understanding as if it is saying, thou shalt commit adultery. So, what do you mean? You take me for a zombie? I said, no, 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 no. I said, look, I will prove it to you. I will prove it to you. So I said, you remember when Jesus went to that upper room where they had the Last Supper after his alleged crucifixion? I said, he goes in and he wishes his disciples, Shalom Aleichem, peace be unto you, in Hebrew, same as Salam Aleichem. When he said, peace be unto you, I said, his disciples were terrified. So why were they terrified? When you meet your long lost master, your uncle, your grandfather, you're happy. The Arab, as he embraces one another, kisses one another. I used to feel very funny before, but I'm used to it now. Some people in the Middle East, they kiss on my forehead. You know, I always feel so funny, you know. But now I'm getting used to it. However, the Arab and the Jew embraces one another. See, his master embrace. Instead of doing that, the guys are terrified. I said, why were they terrified? He says, no, Luke tells us, chapter 24, verse 36, that they were affrighted because they thought he was a spirit. I said, did he look like a spirit? He says, no. Then I said, why should they think the man is a spirit when he didn't look like one? He's puzzled. So I said, look, the reason is I gave all that. Then I said, you know, Jesus wants to assure them that they're not what they're thinking. They're thinking he has come from back from the dead. He's resurrected. So he says, Unzuru ila yadayya wa rijlayya. He says, behold my hands and my feet. Inni ana huwa, that it is I myself. So husuni wanzuru. He says, handle me and see. Fa inna ruha laysa lahu lahman wa izamun. For the spirit has no flesh and bones, as you see me have. And they felt him, and they believed not for joy, means they were overjoyed and wondered. What happened, man? We thought the man was dead and buried. So he says, Aindakum hahuna ta'am. Have you got any here anything to eat? Fanawaluhu juz'an min samakin wa shay'an min shahadi asalin fa akhaza wa akala quddamahum. And they gave him a piece of broiled fish and a honeycomb, and he took it and he ate in the very sight, as if to prove what? That is the ghost, is a spook, is a spirit. No, to prove I'm the same fellow man, damn fools, what are you afraid of me for? I bowled him over, this Arab Christian, that language. So I do learn these snippets are from different languages. I don't know Hebrew, I don't know Indonesian, I don't know, you know, Arabic, but I don't know Spanish, but I can give it to you. So how do I do it? I say, I have a unique way of learning. Unique method, unique. Nobody, I'm a unique person, you know that. There's not another person on earth. No, this is, everybody's unique. Wallah, everybody's unique. Everybody's unique. See, I'm not boasting, but everybody's unique. I told my wife one day that I'm unique. She doesn't believe it. But I proved it to her. She didn't believe it. She's thinking I'm boasting. Nobody like me. I said, no, no, no. I said, I'm unique. There is really nobody like me. She says, no. So I said, you know, in the family, Mr. So-and-so, I don't want to take the name. So she sees, mentally, she sees the fellow. I said, is there another guy like him? So she sees, she says, no. I said, our son, eldest son, my eldest son, Ibrahim. I said, is there another guy like him? So she scans. She says, no. I said, your brother, Ibrahim, her brother. I said, is there another guy like him? So she scans. She says, no. I said, you see, I tell you, everybody is unique. But I have a unique method. It is unique. I said, you see, I use the Bible to learn these languages. Any language I want to learn, I'll go and get a Bible in that language because they got it in 2,000 different languages. And I know the Bible in English extensively by heart. People think I'm Hafiz al-Bible, which is not the case. Hafiz al-Quran is not the case. But it seems at times, Hafiz al-Quran, Hafiz al-Bible, I'm not. But I know this book extensively. I haven't come across a single Christian in my life who knows his Bible better than I know. Alhamdulillah. So because I know this so much by heart, if I want to learn Arabic, I get the Arabic Bible. And I open the verse which I already know. Very easy to learn and understand every word. I want an Indonesian, I went and got an Indonesian Bible. So already what I know, I look for it in Indonesian. I want a Zulu, I do the same. Swahili, I did the same. That's how I learned. That's a unique method. And I want you to do the same. In other words, I'm going to tell you all to go and buy Bibles and go and learn like that. I says no. But what I have in English, the Bible, you have in Arabic, the Quran. I said, use that. You know this? Verses? I said, yes. Now you get an English translation. Look at the verse that you already know. وَإِسْقَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةُ يَا مَرْيَمُ So behold, the angel said, O Mary. Memorize that. Behold, the angel said, O Mary. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اسْتَفَاكِ وَتَحَرَكِ وَاسْتَفَاكِ عَلَى نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ So I said, learn that English. Verse by verse. You know Arabic? Now learn English. Now, once you have done that, your vocabulary is improving. Construction of sentences is improving. Now, an opportunity for use. I said, here around Dhahran, I'm told that there were some 10,000 Americans. I said, they're all your customers. Any white man you see, you ask him, excuse me, sir, what church you belong to? He gives you a name. You know he's your customer. He says, you know, we believe in Jesus. I said, yes. He's thinking maybe you want some cigarettes or chocolate from him. He says, you know what my book says about Jesus? He says, no. It says, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wa isqalati al-malaikatu ya Maryamu. He says, behold, the angel said, O Mary, inna Allah astafaki wa taharaki wa astafaki. I said, do that. Practice, talk. And as soon as you go to Britain or America for studies, you will be on a better wicket. You see, the biggest problem you students have, I know, at that conference, I was told that number one problem when you come to this country, though you have learned English at home, your language, your problem is language, number one. Second year, problem number one, language. Third year, problem number one, language. Fourth year, maybe language takes second place or third place. Some other problems. Language. That's your problem. So I said, no, this is how you master. You do Allah's work. You talk, you read Arabic. Allah give you sawab. Every letter that you read, He gives 10 sawabs, blessings. When you say alif, lam, mim, 10, 30 sawabs. You say bismillahir rahmanir rahim, it's 190 sawabs. So wa is qalatil malaikatu ya maryamu, I didn't count them, but over 200 sawabs. Blessings, you're getting sawab. Arabic is becoming more fluent. Your English is improving. You're getting the courage now. Every time you meet a man, you can talk. You become a talker. You know, if we gave you the opportunity tomorrow morning to ask questions from the floor, not even a quarter of this will be here. You know that? Terrified. I've seen it again and again. As soon as they come and write, flood. A flood of questions. Why? You are terrified to stand up and speak. Why? Because you're not used to. This is it. Stand up and speak, man. Ask. Make a fool of yourself. But as you keep on making a fool of yourself, you'll improve. Catch your customers. Here, man, what an opportunity. 200 million Americans. Everybody is prepared to listen to you in the language which you are now trying to acquire. Talk to him and bowl him over. Talk to him. Improve your English. Talk to him and get spiritual blessings that Allah may reward you here as well as in the hereafter.